Would you like to have a high-tech aquarium with beautiful red plants and intricate hardscape structures, but do you consider the high-tech equipment to be too expensive and a waste of money? If you do, then you're going to get a lot of value from this video, because I'll show you how to make a DIY canister filter using a lot of stuff that you might already have in your home. So if you want to save hundreds of dollars in aquarium filtration, stay until the end and I'll show you how. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need is a bucket. Any old bucket will work. I'm going to use a Home Depot bucket that I bought a while ago for something else. But first, it's orange and it's ugly, so I'm gonna paint it. Please don't judge my painting skills, I'm not a professional. It came out pretty good, honestly better than I expected. Don't paint the inside of the bucket. You don't want the paint messing up the water chemistry. Next, you're going to make three holes in the bucket. Two on the top, right next to each other, and one on the bottom. And here's where your design might start to be a little different from mine, depending on the pump and what kind of filter hose you're using. But as long as you follow the principles needed for this to work, you could do it a thousand different ways. In my case, I'm going to use this submersible water pump. They are less than $20 and they last for a really long time. I use these everywhere. And the coolest thing about it is that they come with all these little attachments, which I'll be using later on. The two holes on the top are for the inlet and outlet. The inlet doesn't have to be anything special. You could even use one of the attachments that come with the pump, if you can find a nut and a rubber gasket for the back. I'll be using this piece that came with an oil filter. It's already broken, but that's okay, because I only need this little section, and I'm actually gonna cut it right here. If you guys are enjoying this video, like and subscribe for more weekly videos just like this. Now, the outlet part is a little tricky. You are either going to need a bulkhead that has a filter attachment on each side, or a bulkhead that is big enough for the filter hose to go through it, because this is the hose that is going to attach to the water pump that will be inside the filter. For this filter, I chose the latter. You need to make sure that the hose fits tightly in that bulkhead, otherwise it will leak. Guys, a canister filter is nothing but a water pump and a bunch of space. I know it sounds simplistic, but the idea is that you have all this space that you can fill with filter media. Then that filter media serves as housing for millions of beneficial bacteria, which feed on ammonia and nitrite and produce nitrate, a chemical that is safer for your fish. For this part, any submersible water pump will work. Attach the outlet hose to the outlet of the pump. When you turn on the pump, the water from the tank will start to flow down through the inlet side. It will go through all the filter media before it reaches the pump, and then all that filtered water gets pumped back into the aquarium. The hole on the bottom of the bucket is for the cable. I'm going to use this waterproof cable bulkhead. When you screw it in, the rubber piece inside of it ties around the cable. The outlet plug is too big to go to the bulkhead. We're going to need to cut it off. I only needed to buy three things to make this filter. The rest of the stuff I already had, I bought the cable bulkhead, this outlet plug, and a gamma lid. Once the cable's through, we tie the bulkhead around it and attach the new plug. I'm going to use these filter tabs for easier removal, but you don't need to do that. You can keep your filter hoses long enough to go straight from the filter into the leady pipes. Now, all that's left is a sponge and a bunch of filter media. What kind of filter media should you use? There are so many choices. My favorite is Seachem Matrix. It's supposed to have a lot of surface area for the bacteria to live on. Fill the bucket up with filter media without going past the inlet, and attach the rim for the gamma lid. Position the filter under the aquarium, attach all your hoses, and fill the bucket all the way up with aquarium water. Put the lid on, plug it in, and you're good to go. Now, and this part is extremely important. When I tried doing this the first time, the gamma lid wasn't strong enough to hold the pressure, and it started leaking like crazy. So I got some Teflon and applied it all over the threads. After doing that, I had no more issues, and it's now working perfectly. So guys, even though making a canister filter is quite simple, anytime you're dealing with pressure, things can get tricky. So you need to make sure that all the openings are really secure. You can use a little bit of Teflon or silicone, just to be certain. And that's how you can make a canister filter using things that you probably already have. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. See you all on the next one.